Many of us remember the story, a man of Jacob, and how Jacob wasn't the best of fellas. Jacob was a bit sneaky. Jacob had a problem with underhandedness. Amen?
Amen.
And just the very mention of Jacob's name eventually led people to believe that he was untrustworthy. So he had a slight problem. And he hooked up with this fellow by the name of Laban. And Laban wasn't in the best form. And eventually he woke up and he separated from Laban. But many years earlier, he did something that was just plain wrong. He stole something that he should not have stolen. Are y'all walking with me? He betrayed his brother. Took the birthright. Got him upset. And his mama helped him. And then helped him escape because his brother Esau was highly irritated and greatly agitated that this boy would take what rightfully was his. Now, I don't know about you, but these fellas tended to hold a long grudge, lasting thereabouts of 20 years. But I even know some church folks. Amen. In 2019, that have not spoken with other church folk in a long time. Amen. Frequent the same store, see one another and walk down separate aisles. Church folk. Yeah, holding grudges so long that you have completely forgotten what the initial issue truly was. Are y'all walking with me? Yeah. Church folk who will raise both hands to the Lord. Are y'all with me? Sing like a mockingbird to the congregation. Shout so loud nobody else can hear anything. But holding grudges for a long time. Well, 20 years or some odd years had passed, and Jacob thought it was necessary to send a message to Esau. He wanted to mend things, make things right, because now God was working in his spirit, and he realized that in order to have a good fellowship with God, he also had to have a good fellowship with God's people. Are y'all walking with me? After all, how can you say that you love God, whom thou hast never seen? And then hate the brother that you see, amen, every day. Yeah. That is a hallelujah spiritual impossibility. And if you think you can, you're fooling yourself. Yeah, Jacob thought it was necessary to get in contact with Brother Esau because he didn't know how Esau felt. He was sorry for what he did, but he hadn't spoken to Esau, and Esau hadn't spoken to him. So he came up with an idea. I'll send a message to my brother Esau. Yeah. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to sweeten the pot a little bit. I'm going to send my messengers bearing gifts. Now, all the gifts I want to go before I go. So I'm gonna send y'all with everything, and I'll be there after a while. Yeah, the Bible says that he sent 200 goats and 20 male goats. Sent all kinds of camels with the babies with them. Sent sheeps, milking calves, and all these things to try to tell Esau, hey man, I'm sorry.
That's what he did.
So here comes the messengers. They come back to Brother Jacob. They say, Jacob, we did what you said, but Esau is coming to meet you. And he's bringing 400 men with him. How many of you know that sometimes when we hear bad news, amen, we forget to go to God who is the bad news fixer. Are y'all walking with me? Now notice, even in verse number 1, he already knew that God was on his side. He already knew that God was working on his behalf. As a matter of fact, he named the camp where he was, that means second army. Are y'all walking with me? Yeah. Two different companies. I have my companies, and God has his special angels all around us. Yeah. I don't know why, theologians don't know why God allowed him to see angels, but he saw them in the camp with him. So he knew that God was on his side. Yeah. But just the thought of Esau coming after him with 400 men made him lose his mind. So he said, all right. I'm going to send my family on the other side of the brook. We on the east side. I'm going to send y'all on the west side of the Jordan to make sure y'all okay. Are y'all walking with me? Esau sent his family on the west side. He stayed on the east side, and he stayed there all night, and he got a visitor. Deacon Knox, he saw a man. And the man began to grapple with him. The Bible says that they wrestled. Yeah. Now, if you study your word and you study it well, you would discover that this was not a figment of his imagination. This was not a vision in his mind. This was a man physically wrestling with Jacob. Now the Bible says that they wrestled to the point that it almost seemed like it was all night. And Jacob felt good about himself because he wasn't winning, but he wasn't getting defeated. Yeah, he said, this man and I grabbed a hold of me, and I a hold of him. Now the Bible says that they wrestled until the breaking of the day. Now Jacob had some duties to do, and he had some places to go, and he had an enemy too, as he thought, to escape. So he couldn't fight all night. But the Bible says in verse 25, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, this man. Yeah, this fella got something on him now. He's staying in the fight. He's enduring the pain. He is going through the motions. He's settling in, and he's not giving up. He's not running away. He's willing to go the last mile of the way. He's staying there. You know, we don't have stick-to-itness anymore. Soon as trouble come, we take off. Are y'all walking with me? Soon as disappointment come, disagreement, we take off. Reverend, when it doesn't go our way, we take off. Leave. Kick dust, kick rocks. Scram. Get up, get out, get in it, get on it. We gone. I ain't got to deal with that. Ain't none of them saved anyway. But how many of you know that there is a blessing when you hold on? There's a blessing we can't give up, regardless of what folks say. Ask Bartimaeus about it. Even when folks try to shut your mouth, you can't give up. Look at you as insignificant. You can't give up. Blessing is on the way if you hold on with all you've got. Sometimes it takes everything, every ounce of will that you have to press through. But press through. Doesn't matter who's in your way. Keep pressing through. Hold on with all that you've got. The Bible says that this man realized that Jacob has some stick-to-itness in him, so he caused him a little pain. Reach down in the hip bone. Snapped it out of socket. Gave him pain and displeasure. Jacob did not count on that. Jacob was not ready for this discomfort. He was not ready for this wrench in the cogwheel. He was not ready because things were going halfway okay. But now there's a problem. But instead of letting go, Jacob held on. My brothers and sisters, we would go through situations and trials and tribulations. It will get painful. It will be uncomfortable. Even folk who should understand won't understand. Even people who should have your back won't have your back. Folk who you should be able to talk to don't want to be bothered. Do all you can to hold on. In misery, excruciating pain, the Bible says that he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint. But what does the word say is, as he wrestled with him. Now look at verse 26, it says, and he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. This is the man talking to Jacob, who won't let him go. Because Jacob has the inside story. Jacob knows who he's fighting with. Jacob knows who he's wrestling with. Jacob understands who he has a hold of. Yeah, he knew that this was the one who said, let there be, and there was. He knew that this was Jehovah Elohim. He knew that this was Jehovah said canoe. Right there in his arms. Now he says, you need to let me go. Jacob said, no. Ain't gonna happen. I've been waiting on this a long time. Are y'all walking with me? Esau's coming from the left. I need you. Gave up all my stock. I need you. Family on the other side of the brook. I need you. No. I'm holding on with all that I've got. Some of us right now are going through an Esau battle. Somebody woke up with an Esau battle. Somebody going to bed with an Esau battle. I just want to encourage your spirit today that God is still on the throne. Still working on your behalf. But the Bible leads us to believe that there is more to this story. Why would not Jacob let go of this man? The Bible says that he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. But then the word of God said, I will not let thee go, except thou bless me. Are y'all walking with me? If you look at some of the study today in the book of Genesis, some folk might believe that Jacob was getting a little arrogant. Some folk might believe that Jacob was testing the law. But if you read in the book of Hosea,
yeah,
round about chapter 12, verses 3 through 5,
yeah,
you will see that when this request was made,
yeah,
it appeared that Jacob had tears flowing down his cheeks.
Yeah.
Are y'all walking with me? I stop by to let you know that old Jacob realized that who he was is not who he is right now. He understood that he needed somebody to help him make it through. He realized that he could not con his way. He realized that he had to go the straight and the narrow path. And now that I got him right here in my arms, I'm not leaving till I receive my blessing. But look what God does. God turns the tables on old Jacob. Now remember, just the name of Jacob made folks think that he's a sneaky man, made folks think that he's a con artist, made folks think that he could not be trusted. But I heard, when you come in contact with God, everything becomes new. I heard somebody say, look at my hands, my hands are new. Look at my feet are new. So God, looking at Jacob, had to change some things about this man. When you're running for the Lord, you have to run with God on your mind. I heard, as they fought and as they wrestled, old Jacob was still holding on to the Lord. But notice what the word of God says. It says, oh Jacob, what is thy name? He said, my name is Jacob. And I believe before he told him what his name was, he was a bit ashamed, a little sorrowful, a little let down, a little dejected, and possibly rejected, because everybody knew about Jacob. Nobody wanted to deal with Jacob, but he had to come clean unto the Lord. I don't know about you, but we got some saints in the church trying to hide their mess from the Lord. But I heard, you must confess all of your sins. And even if you don't, the all-wise, all-knowing, omniscient, omnipresent, all-powerful God Jehovah knows everything that you've done. So Jacob had to come clean in the presence of the Lord. He said, my name is Jacob. And the man said to him, thy name shall be no more Jacob, but Israel. Are y'all walking with me? The word Israel is a compound word. Is Sarah. El is God of judgment. So I stop by to let you know that God is a still real judge, even in today. But notice what the word of God says. And he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince has thou power with God and with man in heaven.
have prevailed that blows people's mind because they think that the word of God means that Jacob prevailed over God. But recognize the turning point in Jacob's life. He realized that he had to be submissive to the will of God. He didn't win, but he didn't lose. I stopped by to let you know that God could have crushed Brother Jacob with a pop of a finger or the wink of an eye, but it leads us to believe that God simply wants our submission unto him. Even when you toil all night long, crying and weeping, God only wants total submission unto him. So it leads me to believe that many of us are not getting our blessing because we have not submitted to the Lord. Still trying to fix our own problem. Still trying to fix our own mess. But when you submit to the Lord, recognize that God has all power. Recognize that there's nothing you can do without him. Those blessings will begin to flow. I heard somebody say they'll come as if you open up a window of heaven. Are y'all walking with me? When you realize that you are not big and bad, when you realize that you're not stronger than God, you will learn how to hold on with all that you've got. Did you not notice that Jacob tried to do things his own way? Sending camels, sending sheep, sending rams, sending ladies to his brother. That didn't do it. But it was the grace of God. He just wanted to be blessed through all of his mess. And if you look in chapter 33, you will see that Esau rode up on him, found him, caught him, walked up to him, looked him in the face, put his arms up, grabbed around his neck, loved on him, rejoiced with him. He said, well, who are these 400 folk that you have with you? They're godly folk serving the same God. Let me tell you, when things look bad, when you give them to God, God will make you terrible into terrific. Are y'all walking with me? Thought it was over for him. But the one he thought was his enemy grabbed him around his neck, bowed down before him. Are y'all walking with me? So we cannot presume what the end will be because God is still in control.